Canada. It's called the Food Valley of Italy. The region of Emilia Romagna, I'm doing my best here, is known for its delicious recipes and products. Think Parmesan cheese or prosciutto. Yes, and here to give us a taste is food historian Francine Segan.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for being here. We were talking to the commercial break. I'm like, I'm going to have to put on this Italian the best I can.
Well, you know, Italian-sounding foods is a big problem because there are people, it's like fake news. So this is the real deal. This is real stuff. And for the holidays coming up, what easier way to entertain than Italian style?
So let's get right into it because this looks delicious.
Does it smell?
I want it all.
So these are some delicacies from Emilia Romagna.
Okay.
Prosciutto. Di Parma.
Oh, I love how you say that as well.
It's so lush in your mouth.
Very.
And you can eat it right out of hand or wrap it around fruit like a fig or grapes, anything. It's so delicious. And
prosciutto, that's pig belly, right?
It's the pig leg.
Pig leg, okay.
Pig leg. It's only two ingredients, pig leg and salt.
Ooh.
Well, four ingredients. A little patience, because it takes 12 months to cure.
Yeah.
And then the wonderful microclimate air of Emilia-Romagna.
This is so perfect when you're going to have your gatherings for Christmas time.
You put this out and the party starts. So here we've got mortadella.
Can I try?
Di Bologna. Certo. It's delicious.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, little myrtle berries, pepper, so yummy. From Bologna. No phony bologna.
No phony.
This is Coppa Piacentina. Coppa Piacentina from the town of Piacentina.
Okay. Look, and that goes well with fruit as well?
Oh, fruit on a sandwich. It makes a wonderful salumi plate. Delicate flavor. Great spices, known for its sweetness.
Mm-hmm. How do you say lovely in Italian?
Bello.
Bello. It tastes good.
And Parmigiano Reggiano.
Okay.
This is the king of cheese.
Mm-hmm.
And so wonderful, especially with a little bit of aceto balsamico tradizionale di Modena.
Oh, just keep on speaking.
A mouthful.
So we have this great platter. Let's get on to the next dish, and let's talk about the region that we're talking about here, because there's
wonderful.
So many. Across Italy.
There are so many regions, 20 regions, but Emilia-Romagna has the most specially protected GOP and DOP, IOP, IGP and DOP products.
Mm-hmm.
So this is risotto verdi for the opera composer. And what we do is make your wonderful recipe, which is on your website.
Mm-hmm.
Then we just add some Parmigiano Reggiano grated.
And then you kind of just mix that in.
And stir it in. It makes it creamy and lush.
I gotta admit, well, I visited Italy 2 years ago, and I had the best food of life. I think I gained like 5 to 10 pounds, but I started in Rome. I went up to Florence, then Milan, and then we went to Venice. It was one of the best trips of my life. Here's a photo right there. Yeah, so that was in Milan. Ooh, yeah.
Ooh, so good. Now, for this risotto,
we
top it with aceto balsamico.
Okay. Does that give it an extra kick?
This gives it that nice, perfect sweetness.
How much do you put? Just a drizzle?
As much as you like.
Oh, so you can have a heavy hand.
Yeah, you know what? If you've never tasted this real stuff, just try this first.
Okay.
So look at how thick that is. It just comes off in drops.
And would you pair this with white or red wine?
Anything. It's wonderful with anything. And you can put
that's lovely.
Isn't that great? And some prosciutto on top of it. And Verdi is a composer from Emilia-Romagna.
Yeah.
And they have a fantastic opera festival that's in the towns of Parma, Rimini, Emilia Reggio. Wonderful, wonderful festival in gorgeous theaters.
Okay. And I'm going to take a bite of this. But what do we have last as well?
Oh, the last thing is so important.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Piadina Romagnolo.
And talk to me about that.
This is a specialty flatbread from the Romagna part of Emilia-Romagna. Emilia-Romagna is made up of two names, and it's wonderful paired with, from the south, the Romagna part, this wonderful flatbread, and then you can pair it with the Parmigiano and some prosciutto.
It's so easy to make, too. Like, you can do
so
it with the kids at home for lunch.
So much fun, because we've also given you that recipe for your website.
Oh, perfect.
So that you can make this. It's a fun, fun flatbread.
Okay, we have to cheers, and we're going to take a bite of this for sure. Thank you so much for being here.
Oh, thank
like,
you.
When we have Italian food, it's the best type of food.
The week of Italian cuisine in the world.
Yes, and if you are in the Toronto area, you can check out the week of Italian cuisine this weekend at Maple Leaf Garden and Ryerson University. Find all the details about these recipes, go to yourmorning.ca. Up next on Your Morning, we're going to cheers first, though.